So in this video, I'm going to be talking about the best time to post on TikTok to actually go viral. Now, if you want to go viral on TikTok, you need to start paying attention to the exact time you want to start posting on the app. Now, knowing exactly when to post on TikTok is one of the best ways that can actually help you to go viral consistently. Because if you are posting on TikTok at the particular time when people are not actually there, when your audience is not there watching, and all that, you will actually find it incredibly hard to actually grow on TikTok. So I'm going to be showing you exactly how to post on TikTok and what time to post on TikTok. I'm going to be looking at the best time for your specific TikTok account. The second thing I'm going to be looking at is how long to wait in between posts. And then the third thing I'm going to be looking at is how long to wait after your post goes viral. The best time to post on TikTok is the first one is in the morning between 10 a.m. to 12 noon. And then the second best time to actually post on TikTok is between 2 o'clock to 3:30. Now, you need to understand that TikTok is actually an app that is geopolitical, right? What this means is that TikTok actually features your post based on your particular location. This means that, you know, this particular time I'm mentioning does not have anything to do with your country, your location, or whatever. Wherever you are, this particular time is actually going to work for you. And the reason it's going to work for you is because TikTok does not look at like everybody all over the world. What TikTok looks at basically is you as an individual, right? It looks at your country, and then it looks at, you know, your geopolitical zone, and like it just looks at the basic area of people that it actually promotes your content to. So TikTok actually picks people based on a particular area. For instance, I'm currently in Nigeria right now, and what happens is that when I post, TikTok actually takes my content first to Nigerians. So it is when that particular video goes viral on Nigerian accounts before that video can start moving to other country, right? So what I need to post is exactly the time that will fit my own country first. Then afterward, I can then start finding out, okay, if it's going to be, then later when the video goes viral, maybe 2 hours, 3 hours, or even 3 days later, then it can start being featured on other countries for you page. So if you are posting and then you have like 3 or 4, 5, 6 content that you want to post, now it's not always good to post a TikTok's video batch to batch. Now, one of the things you can actually do when it comes to posting TikTok videos is that you can actually wait like between 45 minutes to 1 hour in between your posts to actually give your post enough room to determine which one is going viral. Now, this is what happens. Now, whenever you post a video on TikTok, usually TikTok will first of all, you know, feature that particular video on For You page after some few minutes, right? After some few minutes, that video will be featured on the For You page and it will start gaining views. Now, what happens is that when you post another video, now those two videos will start competing with each other to go on the For You page, because TikTok can only put one video on the For You page per time from your account. So those two videos will start competing with each other on which one wants to actually go on the For You page. So if per adventure you are able to just post one video, what will happen is that video will have enough time to go on the For You page and have enough time to actually breathe and gain momentum on the For You page before you actually post another video. Now, this is why you find out that you may not have 2 or 3 videos going viral for you, you know, every day. Now, this is the reason. Now, and this depends on what viral is to your account. Now, every account actually have what viral means to them, right? For a small account, viral video can actually be from 20,000 or 30,000 upward, right? Which then you can then start gaining momentum after 2 or 3 days to even get even more views on that particular video. But for a bigger account, maybe an account with maybe 100,000, viral video could actually mean like 1 million views or even 500,000 views. And so this can actually be what viral means. So for each account, viral is actually different, right? So what you want to do when you're posting a video is that you want to actually pay attention to what viral actually means to your own account. And then if you are posting videos, you want to actually post videos based on, you know, this metric. You want to actually look at it, okay, after I've posted one video, I want to wait for like an hour before I post another video. And then if you have a video going viral, now this is what you want to do when you have a video going viral. Pay attention to this. Once you have a video go viral, what you want to do is that you want to actually give that video 24 hours to actually stay on the account, right? So that you can actually have that video, you can see what that video, the potential that video have to offer. Let me tell you this. For instance, if by virtue you post a video and in 30 minutes or 1 hour, the video, let's say you have a small account like 2,000 or 3,000, and the video starts suddenly hitting 50,000 or 20,000 or 30,000 or 40,000, and this video is actually going viral, you don't want to choke it with another video immediately. So you want to actually want to leave that video and allow it to have some sort of breathing space, you know, to see what that video will do in the next 24 hours before you post another video. And this is another thing you want to do. This is the third thing you want to do when a video goes viral. You actually want to go ahead and go live, right? So if you are not busy at the particular moment and you see a video going viral, you actually want to go live. Now, what happens when you go live is that when you go live, that video will constantly start hitting more milestones, right? The video will start being promoted to even more people because TikTok is actively searching for people to actually join you on the live, right? This is why when you are going live, TikTok will tell you that, see, just hold on, we are going to get people to actually come to your live, right? So they are going to start actively searching for people to come to your live, and the way they are going to do this is that they are going to start promoting your video more and more on the For You page so that people can actually join your live, right? So even if you do not have anything you want to say, people can actually watch your video, right? People can actually watch your video, people can show you love, and people can actually help you to gain what you want to gain. So by actually going live, what you are going to see, you're going to find out is that you're going to see that a lot of people are going to be coming over to actually visit your page and see the videos you're actually creating, and you know, people are going to join you literally. So that's what happens. So it's good that, okay, when you see that your video is going viral, you actually go live to actually make that video to even gain even more momentum on the app. Now, another thing you want to do again when you have a viral video, right? Another thing you want to do again when you have a viral video is that you actually want to look at that video and remake that kind of video again. So instead of you trying to just go ahead and make a completely new concept, or maybe you have already batched some videos you want to actually upload, you can actually pause some of those videos you have batched already and then simply just go ahead and remake that particular type of video that just went viral. You can just recreate it, you know, in a more different way, in a little bit of different style or something, just kind of make something similar to it, maybe the same hook, maybe the same this thing, because what is happening is that as that video is actually going viral, what is most likely going to happen is that a lot of people are going to start using that video and start using that sound and start using that, you know, that hook, and this will now turn to a trend. Now, what happens is that for that video to turn to a trend, what you want to do is that you want to actually capitalize on that video and make even more and more videos on that particular thing, using that same sound, using that same hook, or using that same, you know, that intro or anything you use in that video that made it to, you know, to have that unique feature. So what you want to do is you want to actually remake that video so that, you know, more people can actually hop on the trend and you can actually turn that video into a trend. Now, when your video becomes a trend, what happens is that you gain a lot and a lot and a lot and a lot and a lot more reach, because your video right now is now a trend. A lot of people are using the sound and a lot of people are using the voice, and a lot of people have to watch the video because your video is actually number one on the trend. So a lot of creators, when they are actually, you know, when they are actually trying to post, one of the things that they will be doing is that they will just be like kind of just posting content, you know, when they feel like posting. Now, this is a big mistake that creators make. They just post when they feel like posting. Now, this is something that you should not be doing. Now, you should be posting using the best time that you're actually supposed to post. Now, there are two best times to actually post. I've mentioned the first one, which is general best time to post. And then the second one is actually something I'm going to be mentioning shortly. And this has to do with the best time to actually post for your account, right? So every account actually has the best time to post for them. Now, how do you know the exact best time to actually post for your account? It's for you to actually look at the audience that your account is actually targeting, right? If your audience is just some, you know, some people that are, you know, some students that are going to school, you know that, okay, from 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock, a lot of them are already leaving school, right? But if you're actually targeting adults that are just going to, that are going to come back from work, so by that 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, most of them are still actually at work, right? So you want to actually start posting this video when they're actually back from work, and this will be something like maybe in the night, you know, around 8 o'clock, you know, 9 o'clock, you know, somewhere around that particular time. This is actually one time that you can actually start using to post your videos. Another way to actually know the best time to actually post for your audience is for you to actually go to your analytics and go and check, you know, your videos, the time they went. You will see it right on analytics. You see the exact time that your audience are more online. You know, you will see the chart right there, and you're going to see when your audience are actually more online. So when you look at it, you're going to see it, and then you're going to just start, you know, posting around that particular time, right? You post more and more videos around that particular time, then you're going to be experimenting more with your other videos. For instance, if you have, like, let's say 10 videos, you can post like maybe about 7 of them around that particular time that your audience are online, which is when TikTok have given you a hint that your audience are usually more online. And this hint will usually come in form of your, you know, your analytics, you know, where TikTok is going to put it for you that, okay, this is the time that your audience are more online, right? So you want to post like 7 of those videos and then post 3, you know, just anytime you feel like posting. So you might be wondering, okay, now that I know exactly, you know, what time my audience are usually online, how exactly can I know when time to post? like, when can I post exactly? And you're asking this question. Now, what you can simply do is, you know, pretty much simple. What you can do is for you to just ask yourself, okay, since you have known that, okay, this is the time that your audience are usually online, and you're wondering, okay, should I just post my video right now, or like, when should I post my video? It's very simple. All you need to do is that whenever you know that your audience are online, you actually want to start posting your video at like 30 minutes before the time and 30 minutes after the time. Or you can do it like maybe 1 hour before that particular time or 1 hour after that time. So what you want to simply do is that, okay, if TikTok tells you that, okay, your audience are usually online by 1 o'clock, right? What you want to do is that you want to actually just post your video. Let's say you want to post your video 30 minutes before that time and 30 minutes after that time, right? So let's say your audience are online by 1 o'clock, right? So you want to post between 12 noon to that 1 o'clock, or between 1 o'clock to 2 o'clock, not anytime after that period, right? So that you just want to actually have, you know, no matter what, whether it's before or after, at least TikTok actually have, you know, what it takes to actually promote your video to the to your audience, because your audience are more online at that particular time. Now, and note that when it comes to analytics, what TikTok is actually talking about is that it's your followers that it's actually talking about, right? And these are the people that will engage with your video initially. They are the ones that will drop your first like, they are the ones that will drop your, you know, drop comments for you and drop all the love for you. So you actually want to pay attention to what they're actually doing, right? Because they're going to drop that like for you, they're going to make that video, they're going to give you that initial pushes for that, for your video to start moving out. So another thing again, when it comes to actually, you know, posting the right time to post, is that you need to actually just post good content. Sometimes it's not just about the time you are posting, it may just be because the content is not good enough, right? So what you want to do when it comes to knowing what content is good and what content is not good is for you to simply just go to your For You page, right? Just go to your Explore page, which is the one that is Explore page, where you can search for videos, and just type in the keyword, the major keyword of what you're actually talking about, right? When you're searching that keyword, you want to see the best video that are actually performing in that particular account, like, because the people that are going to rank on that particular pages are the videos that are performing well on that particular topic, right? And when you see those kind of videos are performing well on that particular topic, you want to actually go and remake them, right? You're not stealing their ideas. No, that's not the idea. You are actually remaking those videos. You are looking to actually recreate those videos using the same kind of sound, the same kind of hashtag, the same kind of, you know, a system, or the same kind of hook, like the same kind of system that video was actually made in. Now, the reason is because TikTok is not the kind of app that's always promote something because it wants to promote something. It usually promote things based on the one that they have seen that have done well previously on the app. And I think it's just about the human being that are on TikTok. They interact more with the content that they are used to than the content that they are not used to. So when they see a particular content that they are not used to, they are not most likely to interact with it as compared to when they see a particular content that they are very much used to on the app. So instead of trying to recreate the wheel, you know, you can actually use the, you know, just follow through what has been done already in the past, and you're going to find yourself getting a very good result using this particular strategy. If you love this video, ensure to hit that like button so that I really know that you love it, and then TikTok can actually, no, not TikTok, YouTube can actually push this video to more people. And also, if you are not subscribed to this channel, please ensure to hit that subscribe button, and I will see you in the next video. Take care.